Channel Beck for Tech. So you might have seen the thumbnail, again you might have seen the background image. So this is regarding Googling in this particular era. So at least some of you might ask the question like, what is new in Googling? Or hey Kiran, we all know how to Google something from internet. So I know that, but still there are some things which will be new to you. I believe by end of this particular video, you will get something new. So, we'll not waste any more time. We'll start with the particular video. So again, as you can see in the background image, you can see that I have shown clearly in the image that we do have three methods where we'll be able to input something to our Google server. So the first option is very simple. Like we can type the particular keyword, whatever search tag we need to give it into the Google, that we will be able to type using a keyboard. So that is the first option, or the traditional option, you can say that. So that is straightforward, nothing fancy there. Second option is you can call Google and give the particular search tag. Hey Google, then you can give the search tag. That is another option. Then what the Google does is that it converts this particular voice into the text, and on the reference of the text, it will be searching the internet. So that is also clear. Now, at least now, there is a third option. We can show the Google an image and ask Google to search on similar images. So this is the third option. At least this has been introduced to Google almost a year back, but still even before Google Lens or something similar to that was available in Android platform. But still, this is a fancy feature which we will love to explore. So we'll see all those things. Now we'll see how a search happens. So whenever we are giving a search tag, what Google will do is it will identify this particular search tag and will look into its database whether this particular search tag has been mentioned anywhere. If it has been mentioned anywhere, then it will display the particular document. So this is what normally happens. But let us say there is a document which is named Earth, right? So Earth has got 7 continents. It has got many countries. So India is one among the countries, right? So if someone is searching for India and Google finds out this particular document is named as Earth, it will not consider this particular file because the name of the file is Earth, not India. So at least it was the previously this was happening. But as of now, Google has the computing capacity to at least check into the or some of the files, like look into this particular inside the files to identify whether this particular India is mentioned in any place. So the computing capacity is one thing. And other thing is that we do have large number of or volumes of data. So looking into every nook and corner of this particular database is very difficult. So what it does is it uses some very effective algorithms through which it will be able to look into or find out similarities in this particular data. So we'll not look into the exact algorithms or other things, but we will just explore. Yeah. So next, what we'll do is that we'll explore these options in the computer. So you will be able to identify how these things can be done. Right, so we'll go into the screen. We'll open up the browser. I'm using Google Chrome. You can use any of those options. And inside the search tab, I'm searching for Apple. So it is showing the Apple company. That is the first website I'm getting. And if you could go down, there are Apple centers, which is nearby my place. That is also showing. Then I can get some videos regarding Apple. Then there are images for Apple. Then Wikipedia. These are the things I'm getting in the initial search. Right. Now, next, I can go into news, where I will be able to get the recent news or news, recent updates regarding the Apple. This Apple, it can be the fruit Apple, or it can be the phone Apple, or it can be the Apple TV. So it can be anything. Anything related to Apple, it will be displayed in this particular tab. Now you can go for shopping. There also, you can get, again, Apple is something which is, as of now, as at least as per Google, most of the things shown here are Apple hardware products, right? Next, we will go into the images. Images, again, we are getting some the Apple fruit. Some images are of Apple fruit. Some images are of Apple logo. Then there are different images of Apple logo. Then there is an image where you can see there is a group of apples. Then there are, again, Apple logo. Then there is a poisonous apple. Then there are Apple phones. Then there are Apple products. And it goes on. So it is basically searching the word Apple, and again it is looking at its database, and it is identifying this particular thing. Now this is the first option. We can type in our search tag. As of now, the search tag is Apple, so we'll be getting all these features. Now we'll opt for the second option. Second option is voice tags, right? So I will remove this Apple, and we'll say that we'll go for the again Apple. Again, I will once more will go Apple, right? So it is basically, I will go for Apple, sorry. So we can say that Apple, right? We'll be getting the same thing. So second option is we can input it as voice, and the voice, it will be converted to the text by the default Google search text to speech, sorry, voice to text processing. And that particular text will be searched. Now let us say we'll save something, like this is nice, right? But the file format, I don't know. Yeah, the resolution of this particular image is 641x618. I'm trying to save this particular image. I am saving it in the downloads. It is showing it as download.jpg. So I will rename it as apple.jpg, and saving it. Now, the resolution of this particular image is 641x618, but for my particular use, I want something like a smaller image. So what should I do, right? If I search for Apple, you will be getting all these particular images. So what I should do is, I should click on this particular option. This particular option has got two parts, right? Paste image URL or upload an image. We'll opt for the second option, right? We'll opt for the second option for now. And we'll choose the file, and in the downloads we already saved this particular file, right? So that particular file I'll open and we'll give it. So what Google does is it compares even the tiniest of features of this thing. So all sizes I am keeping it. So that particular exact image, it will be searched in the database. So it will, again, there are results from Facebook. There are results from medium.com. So these are all that same picture reused again and again in different places. So that is what we can identify. Now here what you should do is, I wanted to have something smaller, right? Initially the size of the image was somewhere around 600x600. So I will go into the tools section, and I will use this particular size. I wanted something of medium, or even iconic shape. icon level, right? So if you could click on this particular picture, again the size is 898x875. So we'll go for icon. The size of the picture is 256x256. This is something which I was looking for. So if you are looking for some particular, like some image which is something specific, then you can opt for this thing. You can again save this particular image, and we can click Apple small, right? So this is how you should do. Now we can see I'm going back, and I'm clearing everything. I'm again going for the Apple. So let us say you are someone like a teacher or a creative video creator. So for such cases, you will not be able to use all of these particular images, because this might be copyright protected to some person or some company or some organization. So if you want to use something specific inside your video content or inside your web page, then what you should do is you will have to click on this particular tools, and there is something called as usage rights over here. You might have seen this thing. You might have, I don't know if some people might have used it. So here you will have to click on this particular thing, and you will have to click on Creative Commons License, right? So this images you will be able to use in your videos. If you are a teacher, then you will be able to use these particular images in your videos and or in your PPT presentations, in your, those kinds of things. If you are commercially using it, then you will have to go with this particular thing. Then your sources, like sample contents, will be somewhat lesser in size, and most of the pictures will have something like a watermark or something of that sort. Again, I'm clearing this one also. Now, on the top of, again, this is just, we are searching Apple in the Google search tab. Here you can see, even the Google is identifying this particular search into similar groups. Like, if you want to have red apples only, you can click on this particular group. Here, everything will be red apples. Yeah. But you can say that here one is red, right? So maybe that is why. So if you click on that, only red apples will come. Again, inside the red apples, if you want to have cartoonish part like structures, then you can opt for this thing. If you could again go back, if you want to have Apple logos only, you can click on to that. Again, if you want to have green apples, then also you can have, right? So again, inside the tools, we do have, we can sort these things by many other things, like, let us say, we'll again go back. Inside this thing, you want to have only green apples. So what you will do is, you can click on tools and you can select color. If you click on green, only green apples will come. If you click on something like white, only white apples will come. So the option is there. Again, I am clicking onto any color. Then other option is you can click on the type, right? If you wanted only clip arts, then you will get only clip arts. You want only you want to have only GIF, then you will have only GIF. So this way you will be able to pinpoint your exact specific image, what you have imagined in your mind, right? So this is what you will be able to do. Again, at least by in 24 hours, if you wanted to have something decent of this particular image, at least if you are looking for someone, something recently happened, then you can say, you can give this particular option, like in the past 24 hours, it should be published, right? So this is it for today. Next time we'll discuss something more, like something called as Boolean search, where you will be able to precisely pinpoint one particular tagline from one particular website or something of that sort. So precise, exact searching method. This is called as Boolean search. So we'll look into some of those options. maybe in some other video, because otherwise this video length will become very high. So again, thanks for watching. If you are new to this particular video, please subscribe to our channel so that you will be able to watch similar contents. And comment if you are having any queries. Please press the like button if you like the content. And thank you. Signing off now. Bye-bye.